So, time for some Finnish death grind. I know I played this last night, but it's just so good. Cadaver Incubator, Nightmare Necropolis. Now, what poster to hang up? Or should we do a giveaway? But we'll wait for some more people and then ask them. Because again, I could probably get this signed. So that's a possibility. Guest spots on here, I didn't notice. Like, I've had this tape for like a year almost, but the LP kills it. Original EP, which is probably some of their best material, but Nightmare Necropolis, hell yeah. Like, there's just something in the water in Finland, obviously. I mean, like, even like Rotten Sound, go back and listen to Murder Works, like, it's just so aggressive, nauseam, Gadget. Gadget was definitely underrated and super sick. I used to really like that band, actually. like, really like that band. This is their debut on Hell's Sermons of the Devouring Dead. Great artwork again. Side Grave and Side Violators. We're gonna put on Side Grave. Good record. I really love this band. Yes, I did. Thank you. They always have such sick artwork. Another band that's like better than 99% of other bands out there. Like, I don't even know where you get a t-shirt of theirs. Like, and they have two amazing full lengths and that amazing EP. Like, both full lengths are amazing, but this is just, I don't know, they're equally sick, but I really like Nightmare Necropolis, but this is just fire. Oh, do that? I'm just saying, like, I never saw it, like, out in the wild, you know? Like, when you go to a show, you're guaranteed to see a couple obituary hats, like, you know, the Duck Hunter obituary hats. You're gonna see those. You're 98% going to see one Altars of Madness t-shirt, a Blood Incantation Interdimensional Extinction t-shirt. Definitely probably going to be a four-sided long sleeve. You'll have somebody a little bit older than me wearing like a 2002 Immolation Tour t-shirt. Then you'll have your, you know, just like person that looks like there is legitimately no space whatsoever left on their battle jacket or whatever. And then there's, you know, just people that want to hear the tunes and just enjoy themselves. But it's all gravy. I don't care. Sometimes it's just funny, like, I just remember, like, when kids would show up to, like, especially back in the early, mid-2000s, when I never understood it, like, Because who wants to wear a 2-inch zipper? Like, especially in the BMX community, like, wearing girls' pants was, like, super, super popular. And I just never understood it. Like, just get slim-cut jeans. Like, I don't know. I always liked keeping it tight. And that goes back, honestly, I used to call them Metallica pants. Like, just tight black jeans. Those were Metallica pants. So, like, I don't know. I just always thought it was silly, like, the whole white belt, like, super tight t-shirt so you could see your belly button. It was just weird, like, just a weird time in music, and it's something that I hope doesn't go full circle, but right now, like, there's some stuff that's pretty close to it, but you know, it has not yet been, you know. I mean, like, I'm waiting for it, though. I'm sure there's gonna be, like, some band out there, like, there's gonna be this, like, brutal death metal band that sounds all, like, sick and stuff, and then when you see what they look like, you're gonna be like, oh, man, like, they're gonna look like, you know, all sideways haircut, girl pant wearing, like, dudes wearing white belts and Blood Brothers t-shirts, and that will be the new normal in death metal. That would never happen, don't worry. That would legit never, ever, 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 ever happen. The classics are always going to remain the classics. Like, you could just go back to the Bathory self-titled, for Christ's sakes. Like, that record to me holds up today. Like, it's just gnarly. Just like this is gnarly. Gnarly shit stays gnarly. It doesn't, you know, get corny unless your taste changes. Donation, appreciate it. Cadaveric Incubator, really, I just always felt, I mean, now, you know, they did that split with Necrophiliac, they did that split with Windigang. I think they're getting their due. I forgot all about that shit that they just did with Windigang. I probably should get my hands on that somehow. It's a good, I forgot all about that release. It just popped in my head, like, oh shit, like, that just came out. I don't know how my thumb is bleeding, but my thumb's bleeding. But yeah, if you just came in, we just played, I started with the new Cadaveric Incubator, and then the debut, because it's just all I've been listening to, honestly. I just really, really love it. Extremely good. This is good. I don't know what else to say. Like, I'm not even putting it away. I'm keeping it out, because I know I'm gonna eventually put it back on. And here is a nice lost album, because somebody donated. I cannot play the B-side, though. The B-side is still too warped to play, but the A-side is semi-decent. And this is Bone Sickness Theater of Morbidity on vinyl with the samples. But this was the recalled mix. Like, the whole vinyl got recalled. This is actually my third copy of it. Pretty much came in a pizza box. But I hope when it gets reissued, like, I love the Caligari version without the samples. Like, it's good, but I really do love it with the samples, but, you know, it's a matter of taste, and it's whatever the record labels want to do. But this is a rare one. To feast your disbelieving eyes on the most astounding array of freaks and oddities. Thing from the grave. See the hideous products of God's twisted sense of humor. And that's what that giant flag is behind me. If you didn't know, that's the cover of Theater of Morbidity. The samples are great on here, like the Crypt Keeper one. I do wish they kept them, honestly, I do. Sorry, I love the drumming on this song. Slaughtershed. Keeper. It would be so sick to be able to play this. But I do have to thank Mitch for being super cool about it. Being truthful about it also, I thought was cool, and taking responsibility. Because these got pulled from the shelves and, you know, I still got to keep one. I thought that was cool. They didn't need to do that. But this next album has a ridiculous backstory, which I absolutely love. It's a classic 2002 record from Sweden. and it's just a fun record. It's one of those records, it might not be for everybody, but you can't admit it's not a good time. Always wanted to see this band live too. Like, they always play Maryland Death Fest. And of course I forget the speed. Because I am a poor DJ. But it's the Night of the Ultimate Mosh by Birdflesh. Everlasting Speed Records and Spike Rock. It's like my favorite track on the record, Master of Violence. Great record, Night of the Ultimate Mosh by Birdflesh. I went through like a minute where like all I was listening to was like Birdflesh and like Rotten Sound and a bunch of Scandinavian like grind and stuff. And like when Lang Chi first came out with like Death by 10,000 Cuts, I think, I was listening to that a lot too. That was good stuff. And here's some good stuff too. This band's grown into kind of a monster in a good way. They're on a big label, but I still think this and their first EP is their best material. and one of Australia's best death metal bands. Their new record was really good, but I just think Grotesque Miscreation is just so, so good on Iron Lung Records. It's a beast. 2017. I love this artwork. I love this record. I love this band. It's great. Intro and then seeping Aboriginal fissures. But I look at that cover. You ever played Oddworld's Abe's Odyssey or Abe's Exodus? It looks like something from that game. Badass. I love the red font and I love this album. Enjoy. Lucky enough to become friends with the guys in Faceless Burial, otherwise I would have never gotten any of these records, except for Grotesque Miscreation. I ordered this from Iron Lung. It was either this or Sexless No Sex 2, which was definitely a hard choice, but I really figured people would jump on this Faceless Burial, but they didn't. And this still might, that's what I mean, I would go check the Iron Lung website, because this still might be available. I know everything else is, like, dead sold out, though. Like, if you can find it, just don't pay a gnarly amount of money for it, but seriously, their follow-up EP, I'm just gonna put it on because, like, oh man, this is some, like, straight up, I consider it, like, pretty much Morbid Angel worship. It's just done so extremely well. Just plain black vinyl. But, like, I have a t-shirt for this record. Like, I absolutely love this EP. It's so just, like, perfect. Which made it, like, for me, hard when the full length came, when the second full length came out. I liked it, but it definitely just didn't hold up to this EP. This EP is just their best material. Like, hands down. I love the layout. It's super old school and just very well done. You know what you're getting here. Speaking of contaminated, he's wearing a contaminated t-shirt in this promo photo. Multiverso Avatar. The Xavier Irvine painting is just glorious. I forgot this one's a little warped, but still should play. But here's the new record, Speculation. It's good, but I just feel like this EP is next level. Yes, they do. Bring Golgotha and Remain. And Gutless with them. But I love this EP. Thank you. you never heard Faceless Burial, get into this stuff. It absolutely rips. Switch it up a wee bit. Yeah, why not? Now we listen to this split a lot, but I'm putting a different side on. Oh yeah. Let's speed this up, right? I think it's 45, I forget. But you can't get this anymore because the label doesn't exist. But still amazing. And again, if you don't pay enough, we'll be right back. my own fault. Eclipsing honor and decay. Thank you. like a neurosis part. Like, it actually like reminds me of like early Zaps or like when I first heard it. In a good way. Commodious. It's definitely withering. Defunct Appalachian Noise Records, which always could come back. You never know. But I'm sure this is mad expensive on Discogs. Or not. I mean, I really, it's Commodious though, so most of his shit, no matter what, it's gonna go for a good amount. A new blood incantation. I was given specific instructions on listening to it, and I'm not breaking those instructions. I'll put it that way. Really should have got somebody to get me a copy at the record release, just so we were good. Because Brooklyn Vegan seems to have no idea what the hell's going on with the pre-order. Savagery. Death worship. Not much. Super sore. So why not do a vinyl mix? Make myself even more sore. Although I'm running up on my time limit. What's the best nation? Donation. But I do appreciate the $5 donation. There it is. Appreciate it. This is I really love this band. I know the one dude is in a lot more popular bands than this one, just because I know his name's gonna, of course they use fake fucking names, god damn it, but I'm talking about, oh, Justin Stubbs, I'm talking about, Decrepitat, Death Metal, The Ancient Way, Condemned Cathedral, I Hate Records, out of Sweden, licensed through Razorback, just one of those death metal bands that back in the mid-2000s I fell in love with. And this, and I have the tape over there, the names slipping me at the moment, but I'll find out. The Condemned Cathedral. I don't know. When this came out, I loved it. Like, my favorite Justin Stubb project, probably Father Befal, but Decrepitat is just so crushing. And underrated. But this bad boy. Profaned Doctrines Unburied.
We are church-going people, and we are a law-abiding people. Our police
Goat Thrun reissued it.
And our children grow up to be fine
killer album.
We can be proud of. Because we have had no corrupting influences here to speak
of. I got this in Denver.
Now we find
that where Spectral the Voice played their first show ever.
And threatening to
pretty
steal
sick.
Our children away from us. Yes. Yes. Their image. Their image alone has become a symbol of evil to our young. Their satanic music and subversive lyrics threaten to undermine the very fabric of our society.
I think the dude.
Would you care to hear some of their
forget the artist's name. I'll find out in a second.
You tell me if this isn't the work of the devil himself.
We have the MySpace website. Somebody like Carcass. Cathedral. This is where it's at. Trust me. I love this record so much. Like, this and Frightmare, I used to listen to a shitload of. This Frightmare and the first Goal record, honestly, like, when they had like more of like a death metal thing, like kind of like a, it kind of had like a Necrorot thing going for a little bit. Like it was like punky death metal. It was cool. Ghoul's really fun though. I'm not gonna front. Like Ghoul's definitely fun to see live. But musically, I really don't even know, aside from like their early stuff, like, which I liked a lot, you know. But I heard the one album, it was like, I don't know, it had like surf shit on it, and I was just not feeling it. Wasn't my thing. Oh man, I really hate when I like freeze up. It sucks. Cause like I knew exactly what I was doing, and now I don't even know. Good ones is that. This is a crusher. Sedimentium. Demo 2019. Fucking Kill Records. And they have the demo to themselves. That's how you know that's some good shit. Canada, definitely one of their heaviest. But yeah, they have the Disgusting Geist full length. The Carnal Tomb Crematory Stench split is no longer split, sadly. Demo 2019. Like, imagine your demo getting this much love. You did something right, you know? On those four songs, hell yeah. Because normally, like, they'll do the splits. They'll do the demos as splits, and I really like those, but I think it's awesome when something stands out like this. The Charnel Altar demo, Fetid, Cerebral Rot, Mortal Wound, Gutless. There's a lot of good just demos that are on LP out there. Like, just because I just said it and it's right in front of me. Charnel Altar. They kind of have a lot in common, like the artwork and stuff. This was back when everybody was doing the like spectral voice slimy knockoff stuff, which there was nothing wrong with. I'm just telling it like it is. I'm sorry, but if you don't like it, all you need to do is just, yeah. I have like 90 different shirts that look exactly the same. But it doesn't matter, because, again, when your demo is this good, it gets a vinyl release that's like on heavy duty wax. Has very nice packaging. Like Seed of Doom and Pure Sounds killed it here. Absolutely. Festering Phlegm artwork, but you knew that. Trying to be a jerk, I swear. Twinsies. Caverns of the Hypogeum. I think they're from the Ukraine. Let me find out real fast. And it doesn't say. Rushing now. Thank you. do one more after this. Two more for a dollar. Demo. On Seed of Doom Records. If you're a fan of Death Doom Metal, it's definitely one of the better demos. Like this, the Cavern Rehearsal. Like, that's the real, real good shit. When it comes to modern Death Doom, when everybody went through this little phase of trying to sound like early Spectral Voice, it really did create a lot of cool bands, and I'm grateful for it. I really am. Like, it was like a phase that happened for a couple months, and I'm glad that it did, because, like, seriously, a lot of cool bands put out some cool demos and stuff in that time period. And I got a tape in the mail yesterday. People keep telling me I should check it out, so how about we do that real fast, although I did say I was done. I need to start sticking to my word with that. But I'm gonna put some Grave Ritual on the turntable. Members of Abysmal Lord playing Incantation, worshiping death metal from the swamps of Louisiana. It's awesome. Saw them live and happened to grab a record because I actually had some money back then. And it's a good record. It's one of those bands on Dark Descent I really wish would do, because they played some new tunes when I saw them. Like, I have a live video posted that even says, like, new song. But yeah, that was in like 2017, and I haven't heard anything since. But real quick, let's check this band out. They're on tape. I was listening to the Torso demo because it's still really good. But Deformed, Suffer and Succumb. I keep just getting told that I should check it out, so let's check it out. I know who did the artwork. That's URL. I can just tell. And I was right. Sorry, I'm going back to some impure but not right now, because we just got to do one more. Sorry, but rules are rules. But I appreciate everybody hanging out. Hope you heard some new tunes to go check out. This is Grave Ritual off Morbid Throne. Justin Stubbs from Decrepitap did the cover art. It's kind of cool. No. I still have, but I can't. It's going to be a long time. I wish. I can't. Can't physically do it. There's no way I could do a set right now physically. I'd be willing to do it if we could somehow set up a session drummer for a record release for the three-way split, and we just do like a 20-minute Funeral Doom song. I can do that. Like, run the synthesizer and stuff. Definitely. I love those vocals. They're so just. Vomiting his hatred of Christ now. Awesome. Fucking A. I appreciate you folks hanging out. Appreciate the one donation, means a lot. Cause YouTube taxes the crap out of that stuff, so like that turns into like 32 cents. So I do appreciate it. Like I think after like 4 years I was worth like $300. It's all good. I don't care. I mean, I care because I don't want to go bankrupt, but where am I going to get 900 thou? Like, that's not happening this lifetime. I can tell you that right now. Like, good luck getting that. Like, they won't even let me set up a payment plan because I have no credit. Always pay your hospital bills. Don't use fake names and trying to get out of paying hospital bills in other cities. You're gonna get caught. They caught me. But I'm not putting this on, sadly. That's for me later. I appreciate everybody hanging out. Go check out the bands I played, and I definitely went 30 minutes over what I said I was going to, but it's all good, because, yeah, you got to check out that 1999 Deformed tape, because that sounds really sick, but, yeah, I will talk to you folks, have a good night, thank you again for the donation, and yeah, I'll talk to you guys and girls tomorrow. Again, I still don't have a way to do regular reviews. Like, I can do a regular review, and then just, like, it would be live, and then just, like, stop it. But I just feel the urge to just keep going and just giving you, like, a mixed set and stuff. I keep forgetting I have like certain releases that aren't out yet. I'm not allowed to show you folks. Because I almost played one of them tonight and I'm glad I didn't because I would have gotten in trouble. So I'm looking at it now. I'm like, oh shit, like I was going to play that. Like I'm glad I didn't. Because yeah, I would have gotten in trouble. Definitely not allowed to play that yet. I wasn't allowed to post it. I got like yelled at for posting it. Like, my bad. Like, I thought it was cool because it got announced, but I guess because they didn't get copies yet, that they were like, I don't know what happened, but they didn't seem to be happy that I had a copy before they did. Like, dude, I got the okay to post it, man, but like, they were like, yeah, you just take it down. I was like, yeah. Whatever, but I definitely got the okay to post it, or I wouldn't have done that, because, you know, that's going over somebody's head, and that's not cool. You don't want to do that to people. Don't go over people's heads. It's not cool. But I had permission, so I thought it was cool, but I guess it wasn't. But anyways, thanks for watching, you fucking rule. Else. Good old demonetization.